students, in this part, we will learn the next part of our Unit 1 Problem Solving Aspects. Okay, this is our chapter number 1. In that, in the first part, we have learned about the problem solving algorithms, different properties of algorithms. Now, in this part, you will learn flowcharts and how to convert your algorithms into the flowchart. Okay, so let's start one by one. The flowchart means what? See, in previous session, we have learned this type of exam. Okay, means here algorithm. Okay, algorithm, and here is the one picture. Okay, so to read this algorithm, we need to do the concentration and read this. But to see this flowchart, then say something is a start and then read and these values are some calculations are there and then stop. So what is actually this? See, you know, flowchart is a pictorial representation of algorithm. Means here in which steps are drawn in the form of different shapes. We are using the different shapes to draw the flowchart. We are using the boxes, and the logical flow is indicated by interconnecting arrows. We are using the different arrows to join these shapes. Means flowchart means what? The flowchart is a pictorial representation of an algorithm. Means we are representing our algorithm in the picture form, in which steps are drawn in the form of the different shapes of the boxes, and the logical flow is indicated by interconnecting arrows. Actually, flowcharts are also called as a block diagram or flow diagram, or you can say the system chart or procedure chart. Okay, there is a different name for this flowchart. Okay, sometimes this may be called as a logic charts or Venn diagram or procedure. Okay, so we are using the different notation. We are using the different boxes to show your algorithm, convert your algorithm into picture. So, we are using this connecting lines used to connect the different symbols. We are using this, or you can say the flow lines. We are using the terminal as a start and stop. Okay, so for every flow chart, we are using this start. Okay, start and stop. For both, we are using this terminal symbol. Then, parallelogram, it represents the information entering or leaving the system. Means, suppose you are accepting some data inside the system, or you are printing the data, at that time we are using this for the input and output, we are using the same words. Next is processing. Okay, here we will do all our logical operations. Means, suppose you are taking, adding the two numbers, so write the logic here inside this processing box. And if there is some condition like a decision, A is greater than B, or if age is greater than 18. So at that time, we need to check some conditions. We need to take decision. At that time, we will use this diamond box, and this diamond is known as a decision box. We can use the connector to join the different flows. If there is a different path, different flows, and at that time, so before they terminate, flowchart, you can use the connector, and it's easy to show the different lines in same symbol. Or you can use this call function, okay, use the call function, this type of sub function. These are the different flowchart symbols. See, here is one example. In previous session also, we had learned this example, but this, at that time, this is called the algorithm. Now here see, first step is system, so we are using the terminal symbol start, and we are using the same. So first and sixth number step, start and stop, we are using representing as it is, start and stop. Second step is read the value of R. So here also we are reading the value, read R, read the value. Then say pi equals to 3.14, so pi, having some value, okay, here we are doing the processing, okay, this square box or the rectangle box for processing. So here we are assigning the value 3.14 to the pi. Then after this, calculate the area pi into r into r. So here calculate the area. This is your operation, logical operations in this processing box. And then again use the parallelogram to display the output. Okay, so you can use this for the input and output, this for the terminal symbol, and this square for the processing. Okay, we are using three. Here is some examples of algorithm. You can convert this algorithm into the flowchart. Because now you know that the different notations, so you can take the any example and you can convert it into this algorithm to the flowchart. So let's see the one example here. See, here is a stack. Read input C for the addition of two numbers. Read input A and B. Store the result inside the C. So C is equal to A plus B. Then print C. Then stop. So let's see how to draw the flowchart for this. So I'm using the pen here. So start. So for that we are using this type of a symbol. Okay. So for start we are using this type of a symbol. So you need to draw it perfectly actually. Okay. So take the here you can write the start. Okay. This is for the start. We are using this for the start. So write it properly. It's not possible for me to write correctly by using the pencil, but I'm just trying to show you. Okay, after start, here, read. Okay, for read, which box you are using? You can use the parallelogram box. See here, take the, if the shapes are available, take this shape, or you can draw the shapes. Okay, so, here, you can read the data by using this type of box. Okay, this is your connecting line, start to this. So, read the here, right, but read A, comma B. Then, after this, what is your next step? Next step is my processing. So just process, write the processing here. So write it here. C equals to A plus B. Then again you need to use the parallelogram. Okay. So again we need a flow line. And in that flow line here you can write the output. Okay. Write the output inside this. And then again you can use the stop. Okay. Here you use the stop. Okay. In this way you use the stop. Stop this program. See here we are mapping. Okay, this we are using this. See, we are using this here. See, just we are using these steps here. First is your start. Okay, first is your start. So just use this step here, start. Then after this, read the A and B. So in this parallelogram, read A and B. Then C equals to A plus B. So here C equals to A plus B. Then print. Okay. Print this C. So print the data here. And then last is your stop. Okay. So in this way you can convert your algorithm into flowchart. Okay. You can use this example or for this also the same procedure. Okay. But here only one processing box will be extracted inside this. Okay. Means for the average. And then you can print the average and stop. You can use the same. Okay. And when we are using this example here, then at the time input N, then here you need to use the decision box. Okay, try this example. I have covered this example in theory lecture. So try this example. And mod 2. If S, okay, see if the condition is S, then print even number. If this condition is false, means this number is n mod 2 not equals to 0, then here if no, then print number is false. Okay, if yes, go here. If no, go this side. Okay, these are the different flowcharts. In this way, you can write the different, you can draw the different flowcharts of the given algorithm. And what are the advantages of flowcharts? A good way to communicate the details of a task or a process to others. Okay, you can easily tell to the other the flow of your program. Okay, it is an excellent way of documenting each stage of the process. You can write the each stage. You can draw the diagram for this. Okay, actually it acts as a blueprint guiding the programmer to the development. Okay, it's very easy to understand the flowchart because it is a actually like the diagram, these are the diagrams. So diagrams are easy to understand than the algorithm. Disadvantage. What's the disadvantage? Okay. So Some tasks are difficult to represent using a flowchart. You can't write the some steps inside the flowchart. And if an alteration is made, see here we are drawing the flowchart. See in this example you have drawn the flowchart. If you are trying to add some steps here, then it is difficult for you need to remove this part, then it is necessary to add here the text, here the diagram, the notation, and after this you can add. If there is only a small adjustment, you can do the easy. But if more than one or two or three small pages is imported in between, then you need to select all the remaining part, delete it, and then draw the new diagram. So see, and why I am telling this, see, if an alteration is made, if there is alteration, okay, then it will take a time. Okay, if an alteration is made, then the flowchart may need to be redrawn. Okay, you need to draw the flowchart again if there is a many changes. Okay, people need to understand what the symbols mean, and it is also important which symbol, where to use the rectangle, where to use the parallelogram. So it is necessary to know the first all the notations of the flowchart. And here is the difference between the algorithm and flowchart. Okay, algorithm is a step-by-step procedure to solve the problem. And flowchart means what? Flowchart is a diagram created by different shapes to show the flow of paper. Okay, what it will show? It will show the flow of paper. Algorithm is a complex to understand. These are the complex to understand, but the flowchart is easy to understand. In algorithm, plain text are used, but in flowchart, we are using the shapes. Okay, algorithm is easy to develop, and flowchart it is hard to develop. Hard to find out the form. Algorithm is difficult to construct, and flowchart is a simple. You can construct the flowchart in easy way. But the algorithm does not follow any rules. The flowchart follows the rules to be constructed. Because there is a different notation, you can't use the any notations for anything. Okay, there are the rules. For input output, there is a separate symbol. For processing, there is a separate symbol. Algorithm is the pseudo code for the program. And flowchart is just a graphical representation of your logic, means the flowchart. And this is the difference between the algorithm and the flowchart. Okay. In this part, you have learned about what is a flowchart, then notations of the flowchart, then simple example of the flowchart, then you can convert this algorithm to the flowchart. Try these two examples also to convert it into the flowchart. The advantages, disadvantages of the flowchart, and the difference between the algorithm and flowchart. Thank you. Thank you.